Esteemed guests, captains of the industry, and the people who are going to take AP forward, I really would like to thank you for the opportunity, and I am really honored to have been chosen to address an August gathering like this. Incidentally, when I accepted this offer, I was the Congress Party's General Secretary and the spokesperson for the party at the state and national level. Thereafter, I was given the responsibility of being the chairman of the Andhra Pradesh Minorities Commission, which is a judicial authority and which in some way bars me from speaking totally politics. But being a concerned citizen of this state, and because I had already accepted the invitation not to let down my friend Sangeeta ji, I decided to speak, but I will only speak on the aspects of the development and what my government has done from the last 9 years. And what responsibilities we should have in taking the straight forward. And it will be truly, as I've been told by the moderator also, that it will be truly on the lines of economic development and the atmosphere which is going to be provided to you people to develop Andhra Pradesh as a model state. It is a fact that today, any industry which is coming to Andhra Pradesh or anywhere in the country or anywhere in the world would like to look at the atmosphere prevailing in that state more than the infrastructure, because it is a matter of personal security, it is a matter of security of the people who are going to put in their hard-earned money, it is a matter of the employees who are going to work there. So in that way, I am proud to say that Andhra Pradesh has one of the best atmosphere. We have a system wherein we have got all type of people from the country staying together socially and also have gelled together, and that Hyderabad today can boast of a state or a city, or Andhra Pradesh can boast, where we have all type of people from all parts of the country coexisting, enjoying themselves and then being happy, and also totally the whole Hyderabadi culture has adopted them and they have adopted Hyderabadi culture. I'm proud to say that. I think I will start with a negative fact before, because I would definitely not try to boast of what we are doing. The negative fact which I come to understand from the situation is about the power and the political uncertainty because of particular agitation. So as far as power is concerned, definitely we need to do a lot more. Our CM is concerned about it. He has been regularly working on it, and there were some issues about the Godavari gas basin. There were some issues about the surplus gas which has to be allotted to us. We are working very seriously, and I feel that the 50 million unit which we are having a shortfall now can be covered up with a good monsoon as well as some sort of change in the cap on the gas, and we get more gas and then we are able to generate more power and we are able to give the power required to the industry, because as far as I know, because with all my friends from the industry, that this is one of the major concerns, and we are government and state is seized of it, and definitely we assure you that before you raise that question, that we will work on it and we will try to provide the required number of units so that the industry can flourish. We are also working very seriously on the solar energy front also to sustain the villages and the requirement of the pump sets, which is also drawing lot of power from the grid. Now, basically, I would like to spell out that any state which needs to sustain has to take all the sections of the people and their development together, because indirectly it adds to the growth of the state. In a particular, I will only cite one or two examples. I will cite the examples of SCSTs, which contribute to a population of 23% of Andhra Pradesh, minorities which contribute a population of about 11% from Andhra Pradesh. These were the sections which have been held by all the reports to be much behind all other sections of this thing. So here we have been working on a plan, and we have been working very successfully on a plan where we provide these people as a workforce to the industry at well trained and well tuned to be a part of your growth plan. In Andhra Pradesh, I am proud to say that about a lakh and more of engineers have graduated in the fees reimbursement scheme without paying any amount to the colleges, and these engineers have become a role model for the whole country. Today they are abroad, they are in India, they are a part of the software, this thing. This has created a very big bank, trained bank for people where the industry can draw them for their purposes. Likewise, we have also been working on Rajiv Yuvakiranalu, which is a unique program in itself, which provides for training, placements, and then also providing the people required opportunity in the industry where they can get suitable jobs. Apart from this, we have been in the last 3 years, as you are aware, we have been working on various plans. We have been working on a scheme where we are providing a single window clearance for all the industries. We have been working on a land acquisition plan. Our central and state government has formulated a policy where land is available to the industry at a reasonable price and a reasonable time so that the industry can approach the requirement. We are also working on a policy on the industrial loss. We are also working on the required infrastructure like roads and all.